Health in Cambodia, Wikipedia audio. The quality of health in Cambodia is rising along with its growing economy. The Cambodian population and healthcare system struggles with many of the diseases common to the tropics, in particular in rural areas. In addition, malnutrition of children has long been a major problem. HIV became an increasing problem in 1998, but the epidemic has since been almost curbed. The public health care system has a high priority from the Cambodian government, and with international help and assistance, Cambodia has seen some major and continuous improvements in the health profile of its population since the 1980s, with a steadily rising life expectancy. A health reform of Cambodia in the 1990s successfully improved the health of the population in Cambodia, placing Cambodia on a track to achieve the Millennium Development Goal targets set forth by the United Nations. As a result of the reform, mortality rates significantly dropped. Similarly, life expectancy at birth in 2010 was 62.5 years, a 1.6-fold increase from 1980. On the other hand, there exists some problems that needs to be addressed. For example, in 2005, total healthcare expenditures accounted for 6.4% of GDP, the highest in Southeast Asia. In addition, in 2015, 61% of the total health expenditure had been estimated to be provided by out-of-pocket payments, which might be unaffordable to the poorer segment of population in the country. Introduction. Cambodia gained its independence from France in 1953, but the road to self-governance would prove to be very difficult. In 1967, the Cambodian Civil War broke out, and the following decade turned out disastrous for the country and the Cambodian people. The Vietnam War spread across the border, and the U.S. initiated massive bombing campaigns in Cambodia, which further aggravated the civil war and destroyed infrastructure and agricultural resources in the entire eastern half of the country, in particular the rural areas. In 1970, a coup d'état, supported by the United States, brought down the Cambodian government of King Norodom Sihanouk, and the Khmer Republic, an unstable military republican regime, was installed. As the civil war progressed, the regime was eventually overthrown by the Khmer Rouge in 1975, and in the aftermath, an internal genocide began, further destroying the economy and the capital city, massacred intellectuals, and crumbled the country apart, resulting in the deaths of around 1.7 million people in total. The Khmer Rouge came to a demise in 1989, and the United Nations took over and sponsored a national election that supported numerous developmental agencies and non-governmental organizations to come into Cambodia, which helped in the rebuilding of the country. Cambodia is officially no longer a country of military conflict, as it has experienced a period of relative political stability in response to the 1998 election. As a response to the political stability, the country has experienced significant and consistent economic growth, but from a very deprived foundation. To be specific, Cambodia experienced a gross domestic product increase of more than 7% per year. As of 2012, Cambodia has reached GDP per capita of $944, right on the verge of achieving the threshold for lower middle income country status of $1,035. Although the economy has been growing, the gains have not been equally distributed. Most of the income gain has been distributed exclusively to the urban population. Inequality in healthcare persists between people of different socio-economic backgrounds, most prominently contrasted between the rural and urban population. According to the CDHS data in 2010, the rate of children under 5 with moderate to severe malnutrition or with acute respiratory infection was more than twice as high in children living in rural areas compared to those living in urban areas, as well as children in lowest quintile household compared to those in highest quintile household. Dual burden of disease refers to the prevalence of both infectious and chronic disease in each population, mainly due to shifts in diet and physical activity pattern in response to globalization, especially in the low and middle countries. Currently, rate of non-communicable diseases occurring in Cambodia has been rising, and mortality due to non-communicable increasingly matching up with the number of death due to infectious disease. Such dual burden/epidemiological transition from infectious to chronic disease burden has been identified, as the burden death due to infectious disease has shifted towards deaths due to injuries and chronic diseases, Bush as cardiovascular disease, cancers, and respiratory diseases. Malnutrition remains to be a major risk factor for children's health. Childhood stunting, wasting, and underweight due to malnutrition remains to be a problem in Cambodia. Mortality data suggests emerging burdens specifically from injuries, high blood pressure, heart disease, and liver cancer. Average life expectancy at birth was determined to be about 71.4 years in 2012. Specifically, the average life expectancy for females has been 74.2 years, and the average for males has been 68.8 years. This is a significant, more than 2 times longevity increase from only 29.6 years in 1980. Major infectious diseases include a very high risk of food or waterborne diseases including bacterial and protozoal diarrhea, hepatitis A, and typhoid fever. Vector-borne diseases include dengue fever, Japanese encephalitis, and malaria. Cambodia has been certified as being polio-free since October 2000. Tuberculosis incidence and prevalence declined significantly, and within just 20 years from 1990 to 2010, the incidence rate declined by 25%, and the prevalence rate declined by 48%. Efforts through active screening, such as outreach activities conducted by the National Center for Tuberculosis and Leprosy Control, and introduction of directly observed treatment short course in 1990s drastically reduced burdens due to TB in Cambodia. Malaria remains to be an endemic in the rural Cambodia, affecting more than 3 million people. Although the reported cases of malaria and malaria mortality have decreased, since the disease is more prevalent in the rural areas where there are no public health facilities that keeps track of the numbers, the actual number of cases are expected to be much higher. Healthcare inequality. Dengue fever is especially prevalent among children in between 4 and 6 years old, living in urban Cambodia. Dengue fever was introduced in Cambodia in 1980. The incidences have been increasing since then. However, the case fatality rate has decreased from 15% to 0.3% from 1980 to 2010. HIV emerged as a major infection affecting the lives of approximately 2.4% of the population in the 1998. Major public health work has been done to reduce the prevalence rate through implementing education and promoting safe sex via condom use targeted to specific population groups who are at the core of the infection web, including commercial sex workers, injecting drugs users, men who have sex with men. Some of the interventions implemented include awareness of safer sex and condom use campaign, universal access to HIV testing, and prophylaxis to HIV-positive mothers to reduce mother-to-child transmission of the virus. Cambodia's HIV/AIDS epidemic is spread primarily through heterosexual transmission and revolves largely around the sex trade. HIV transmission occurs mainly in sexual partnerships where one partner has engaged in high-risk behaviors. Women constitute a growing share of people living with HIV/AIDS, comprising an estimated 47% of people living with HIV/AIDS in 2003, compared with 37% in 1998. This increased proportion of infections among women may reflect declining prevalence rates among males, as well as deaths among males infected in the early years of Cambodia's epidemic. Significantly, a low prevalence rate in the general population masks far higher prevalence rates in certain subpopulations, such as injecting drug users, people in prostitution, men who have sex with men, karaoke hostesses and beer girls, and mobile and migrant populations. By 2014, HIV prevalence was reduced to 0.4% through a successful prevention program. However, in 2015 a massive outbreak of HIV stemming mostly from Roca occurred. The cause is thought to be the reuse of syringes by an unlicensed doctor operating in the region who has since been jailed. A survey from Mo done in 2010 indicated that 2.9% of population among adults aged 25-64 years had diagnosed diabetes. Similar, 11.2% of the population among adults aged 25-64 years self-identified as having been diagnosed as having high blood pressure. Dual burden of disease. Life expectancy. Since 1996, reported incidences of death due to injury have increased drastically in corollary to increasing number of vehicles. According to the health data from Mo, being male and being a motorcycle rider contributed most significantly to the burden, accounting for 80% and 67% of all mortalities due to injuries in 2010, respectively. Common health problems. Infectious diseases. Tuberculosis. Malaria. Dengue fever. The 2015 maternal mortality rate per 100,000 births for Cambodia is 161. This is compared with 290 in 2010, 265.8 in 2008, and 409.1 in 1990. The under 5 mortality rate per 1,000 births is 90 and the neonatal mortality as a percentage of under 5's mortality is 34. In Cambodia the number of midwives per 1,000 live births is 6 and the lifetime risk of death for pregnant women 1 in 110. Prematurity, pneumonia, birth asphyxia, diarrhea, and injuries remain the top 5 killers of children under 5 years of age in Cambodia. Notably, the rate of diarrheal disease and measles decreased significantly in response to high vaccination coverage campaign set forth by the Ministry of Health. Unsafe drinking water and lack of sanitation facilities are major risk factors of infectious disease, especially diarrhea. However, such sanitary conditions have been improving since the 1990s with the economy and governance of the nation. Specifically, in 2010, it was estimated by the WHO that around 64% of the households were able to receive safe drinking water, with urban counterparts of the country receiving higher rates of improved water than the rural counterpart. Ministry of Health. Ministry of Health in Cambodia has been taking the leading role in improving the health of the people in Cambodia. Established in the 1990s when help from the NGO and external government aids were welcomed in Cambodia after the relative political stability. Thanks to the MO, Public Health Administration governance has been centralized and organized so that decisions and actions are facilitated to act quickly and critically in response to public health problems. Specifically, the MO follows the current Health Strategic Plan 2008 to 2015 to better the health of the nation. HIV/AIDS. Under the supervision of Cambodian Ministry of Health, governmental health facilities are reimbursed for treatment of the low-income patients. In 2012, it was estimated that subsidies were given to around 25,000 inpatients and outpatients, with total expenditure adding to $285,000. However, such governmental infrastructure is not available in the rural provinces. NGOs take bigger roles in the rural healthcare setting in Cambodia. Health indicators in Ratanakiri are the worst in Cambodia. Malaria, tuberculosis, intestinal parasites, cholera, diarrhea, and vaccine-preventable diseases such as measles are endemic. Ratanakiri has Cambodia's highest rates of maternal and child mortality, with 22.9% of children dying before the age of 5. Ratanakiri also has the country's highest rates of severe malnutrition. Ratanakiri residents' poor health can be attributed to a variety of factors, including poverty, physical remoteness, language, and cultural barriers that prevent Khmer Lou from obtaining medical care, poor infrastructure and access to water, lack of accountability in the medical community, and exacerbating environmental factors such as natural resource degradation, decreasing food production, and internal migration. The province has 1 referral hospital, 10 health centers, and 17 health posts. Medical equipment and supplies are minimal, and most health facilities are staffed by nurses or midwives, who are often poorly trained and irregularly paid. Note, these statistics are aggregated for both Ratanakiri and Mandalkiri provinces. Chronic diseases. Diabetes. Hypertension. Injury. Maternal and child health care. Public health in Cambodia. Humanitarian and health aids organization and governance. Governmental subsidies. Regional, Ratanakiri. Statistics. Sources and further reading.